Welcome, everyone, to the Masked Singer season finale.
We're ready.
Yeah.
It is the night we've been building to over a season.
Yeah.
That's right.
Queen after queen have been crowned and knocked out, but we are down to our final two, the Heart.
Yes.
And the Lambs. Now, how do you guys feel about tonight? It's some real competition.
This is the stiffest competition. Ooh. This is the toughest finale ever.
I know we say that every season, but it's only because we keep leveling up on this series.
Absolutely.
Yeah. It's hard because it is three with the Lambs, three against one.
Three against one.
But Harp, she holds her own.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
That's right. That's right.
Well, we will see. They'll start with an anthem that means something personally to them. Then they'll put their own unique twist on a pop classic. At the end of the night, both competitors will finally be unmasked.
Yeah.
But only one will go home with the coveted Golden Mask trophy right there. In just a moment, our first finalist takes the stage with her personal song. But before that, let's see how she became the Harp.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Becoming the Harp has been unlike anything I've ever experienced as an artist. When I step into this costume, I'm transformed. I feel regal, elegant, and totally weightless. Which is ironic, because this thing is no joke to cart around. But really, it's spring. Being under the mask has allowed me to separate myself from the former jobs, my name, what people expect from me, and prove myself with just my voice.
Do you guys think that she is an actress?
I think she's a triple a threat.
No matter what happens tonight, I'll always be the Harp.
And we are on the edge of our our seats. What a way to kick off the finale.
Girl, you put every award show to shame just then.
Wow.
Because that was by far in all eight seasons the best performance I have ever seen in a finale show.
Really?
Ever.
Outstanding.
Really?
Sis, that's how it's done right there.
Yes.
You got what it takes no matter what to go all the way. So congratulations to you after that performance.
Yeah. So well said. Now, are you guys picking up on who the heart might be?
I know exactly who this is because I've been saying it from Jump Street. I'm saying someone who has won Oscars, performed in stadiums, someone who's performed for president, someone like, oh, I don't know. Can I get an amen? That's right. In the beginning of the season, talking about being on the biggest show of all time, Jennifer Hudson was on American Idol, but in The Journey, she was also known for comedy. I know Jennifer Hudson's not known for comedy, but she kind of crushed it in a little movie called, oh, I don't know, Sex in the City. Kind of amazing, right? She was hilarious and even made Miranda laugh. She's a tough critic. After tonight's emotional performance, I'm going back to Jennifer Hudson.
That's one for Ken right there.
That's like the third time he hasn't been booed this season. So you guys,
how dare you?
You guys are real nice.
You know, from some of the first clues that we saw, I've been stuck on the comedic tip. Early on, I thought, well, maybe it's a triple threat, somebody like Queen Latifah, right? But that's not Latifah's voice. Then we saw an Oprah clue, and I remembered that this person also famously does an Oprah impression. You've worked with her. Triple threat, comedy, music, and acting. I think this is Yvette Nicole Brown.
Oh my goodness, that's a great guess.
That's who I'm going with.
I love it.
And he never guesses his co-star correctly, so you're probably right.
Very true.
That's the lucky charm.
My money's on Robin so far, Nicole.
I love that.
Okay, so look here. We saw the purple mashed potatoes. That made me think of Fantasia, okay? Because she was in the movie musical of A Color Purple, and we saw the number one trophy.
But her voice is like, Fantasia's is higher.
I'm getting there, Jenny.
Okay.
But then, with her powerhouse voice and that tone, I suddenly went back to what I felt in my gut from the beginning, you guys. She told us she auditioned for a big show and didn't make it because she didn't fit the mold. I think that show was American Idol. But the show that she did get, the show that was a cultural phenomenon, was Glee. She's played Effie in Dreamgirls. She's also been in The Wiz Live. I think this is the amazingly talented Amber Riley.
Wow.
Wow.
All right, Jenny, what you got?
Okay, so there was a TV remote, and I thought, okay, first Wives Club reboot, Jill Scott has a voice like this.
Jill Scott, great singer.
And then I was thinking when I saw the first place trophy clue, this could be Jordan Sparks who won American Idol.
Mm, nice.
I like that one.
Whoever you are, you pulled at all of our heartstrings this entire season. We truly cannot wait to see who you are.
Yeah. Indeed. Y'all keep it going for the harp and that amazing performance.
Harp has been pulling at the panel's heartstrings all season. But are any of these guesses right? We'll find out tonight.
I thought that was her most confident, flawless performance
peaked,
the
right?
whole season.
She peaked at the finals.
The biggest question is, how in the heck are the Lambs going to compete with that performance? What do they have to do to try to win?
I mean, there's three of them. They're their own powerhouse.
Welcome back to the finale of The Masked Singer.
Yes!
The Harp has been a vocal powerhouse since day one. Let's take a look back at her journey to the finale.
When I started this journey, I had no idea just how much this competition would mean to me. I've spent years in an industry that doesn't necessarily celebrate who I am all the time. In Hollywood, you can be overlooked based on a more shallow viewpoint, but being able to be the harp and step out in just my talent alone has been absolutely amazing.
Don't make me close one more door. I don't want
hit on that stage in Masked Singer history.
This opportunity has allowed me to reintroduce myself to the world on my own terms. And hearing the panel's words of encouragement week after week has reminded me that I am more than enough.
You could sing the phone book and make me cry with a voice like that.
I want to win it not just for myself, but for all the other girls who have ever felt less than perfect. Do not underestimate us. We have greatness inside, and the world needs to see it.
I'm gonna cry. That was beautiful.
Robin.
Wow. I mean,
right?
I thought the opener was spectacular. Wow. I mean, that is hands down one of the best things we've ever heard on this stage. Ever. Ever. And we always talk about this, being able to take something and really, truly make it your own. We, you know, that's an incredible John Mayer song with a completely different feel.
Yeah.
And you just took that into the stratosphere, to the church, over the moon. Oh, my God. That was pure.
That's right. You are anointed, sis.
Woo.
Because when
yes.
I watched you stand up there in your stillness, I was like, that is the power of God
yeah.
in her right now.
Amen.
You are truly one of the best that has ever graced our stage. Thank you.
Oh, man, look
oh.
at her. She's crying.
She's crying.
And obviously, we can't see her face, but I can hear that the harp is quite emotional right now. I just have to ask you, harp, what's going through your heart right now?
These are people that I admire. A Beautiful World is one of my favorite songs
oh,
that I listen
you.
To all the time. Nicole, I watched you since the very beginning of your career and have admired you. I've watched you all. And it just means a lot to be validated. I've been through a lot in this industry, and sometimes you forget who you are, and sometimes you need people to remind you. So oh. I thank you.
I mean, to think that you ever felt less than or not enough, I hope after that performance, you know that you are more than enough. You are loved. That was epic, and we all love you.
Well, Hart, you left it all on the stage and then some. Woo! They're standing up for you once again. You've been an amazing competitor.
That was incredible.
Ladies and gentlemen, keep it going for the Hart one more time.
Woo!
Men
Woo!
In Black, help her out. Okay, panel and studio audience.
Uh-oh.
It's time for the final vote of the season.
Oh, man.
The performer with the most votes will be crowned the season 8 champion.
I'm stuck. I don't know. I'm honestly stuck. I need help, and I don't know, because I love them both. What do I do?
May the vote be with you.
The final results right after the break.
Oh, my God.
Welcome back to the season finale of The Masked Singer.
This is it, the final.
I don't want it to end.
Two mystery finalists stand before us. Each has proven they are worthy of the Golden Mask Trophy, but only one can be crowned queen.
This is intense.
Harp and Lambs. Let's get to it.
Oh my God.
The winner of the Golden Mask Trophy, the queen or queens of season 8 is
I can't believe this is it, you guys. I'm scared.
Oh,
I'm
man.
Crushing your hands, I know it.
Jenny, you're hurting my hand.
The Hart!
Hart,
congratulations! The Golden Mask Trophy is yours. How does it feel?
It feels amazing. It feels so amazing. I'm so excited. Thank you.
Please. Make your way to our winner's circle.
She earned that.
She earned it.
And keep it going and show some love to the Lambs, of course. Yeah.
What a great finale.
Right?
All right, Lambs. Welcome back to the Masked Singer finale. Just moments ago, we found out that the Hart has joined the ranks of past season winners like T-Pain, Wayne Brady, Candy Burrs, LeAnn Rimes, Nick Lachey, Jewel, and Teyana Taylor. Which famous face will join our esteemed Hall of Fame? Before we find out, let's have the panel give us their final guesses. Who wants to start?
I'll start.
All right.
You know, I've been on this Yvette Nicole Brown tip for a while because she's definitely a triple threat, but she also had a deal with Motown Records many years ago, so a lot of people don't know how talented of a singer she is. I think that this is Yvette Nicole Brown.
Great guess.
I like it, but I like mine a little bit more. The TV remote, because she got her start on TV, American Idol. And guess what? There was another clue that said first place trophy, because she won American Idol. I think this is the beautiful, very talented Jordan Sparks.
Not a bad guess at all. Hard to argue with.
Ken, what you got?
I honestly think in my heart, I've been right all along. Someone who is a triple threat, she sang an amazing John Mayer song, Gravity, and no one
has more gravity than my guess. This has to be Jennifer Hudson. Yes. Yes. Yes.
I need this. I really need this.
Nicole, what about you?
Okay.
Come on, Nicole.
She said she collaborated with me, which she did, on our dear friend Todrick Hall's album. And you guys, I can't believe I'm just getting it now. The Wizard had, yes, she was in The Wiz Live because I loved her in that. But the album that we collaborated on was called Straight Outta Oz. This is the gorgeously talented Amber Riley.
Okay, our panel has made their final guesses. Let's see if any of them are correct.
Oh my God, I'm so excited right now to find out who you are.
Who is behind the mask of our season 8 winner? Harp, we need to know, who are you?
Who are you?
Audience, say it with me. Take it off. Take it off.
Take it off.
Take it off. Jennifer Hudson.
Take it off.
Take it off. This has to be a surreal and well-deserved moment. Tell me what it's like winning the Masked Singer.
This has been such an amazing experience, just to be able to come out here and be completely covered and let my talent speak for itself.
Yes.
And the love that I have for people and wanting people to heal and feel what it is that I'm singing. So I hope everybody felt my soul because I bared it right here on this stage.
Your entire journey, we felt your soul indeed. And somebody who was picking up on your soul sister right there,
I'm
Nicole Scherzinger.
I just love you. I've always been a fan of yours. I've seen you perform live in person. It's like, it's chills, it's goosebumps, it's transcending.
Thank you.
We love you so much.
Thank you, everybody.
In the building.
Now, Amber, do you feel more than enough?
I do. I feel more than enough.
Good. You should.
Besides a trophy, that's what I'm taking home with me. Everything that you guys said to me earlier today. You made me cry. You messed up my makeup.
So is there anything that you would like to say to your adoring fans, friends, and family watching this moment?
I just want to say, whatever it is that you want in this life, you go after it. It may be hard. It may be a rocky journey. But at the end of that journey, it will totally and completely be worth it. So keep going.
Yes.
Yes, girl. Yes.
Yes.
Such beautiful words from such a beautiful harp. It has been truly a pleasure and an honor to have you here. Let's give it up one more time, y'all, for Amber Riley. It's been an incredible season. Thank you to everyone at home for joining us on this wild ride. We'll see you again in the new year for an all-new season 9 of The Masked Singer. But right now, here to sing us out one last time, unmasked once and for all, the artist formerly known as The Harp, our season 8 winner, Amber Riley.